We will use the git push to transmit the local branch commits into the remote repository. And what if we want to do the opposite? Okay, we'll go here and I create a new README, and I'll go for that. Let's just save that and commit a new file. Now I have a new change, but I don't have the same change within this local repository. Now I have this readme.md, and if I do an ls here, you don't find this file right here. So we don't find this readme.md. Even if I'm using this git status right here, it's going to give me a lot, nothing, and nothing to commit to working tree clean. But the problem is this web project right here, or this remote web project, is one commit ahead of this local one. And to do that, I don't have to push, because I have nothing to push into the remote repo, but I need to do the opposite. In this case, I need to use git pull, which will pull the modifications of the last commit, because the last commit right here is create the md readme.md file. And once I do this git pull, now let's just wait a little bit. And as you see here, I have this readme.md and while file changed. And if I do an ls, now I get access to this readme.md file. So use git push if you want to push the modification from the local repo into the remote repo, and use the git pull to pull the modifications from, or pull the commits from, this remote repo into this local repo.